Hello, hello, it's Asia here with a new video for a Purple Vibes YouTube hop. I will talk to you a little bit more about the hop later, but for now let's just focus on what I'm doing here. So as you've seen, I added a layer of gesso on my canvas because the canvas wasn't primed before. And now I am mixing modeling paste by Tabeo with some fine grain texture paste by Rico Design, and I will be using a stencil by AB Studio, stencil number 59. AB Studio is one of our generous sponsors, and you've seen the full list of sponsors at the beginning of this video, and I will also add it in the description box below. So big thanks to them for the generous prizes they are offering. And now back to my project and another two generous sponsors. First one is SnipArt, from which comes this beautiful chipboard. And then Lindy's Gang. I'm using embossing powders from Lindy's Gang. And I will be doing a layered embossing. Firstly, I will emboss it in black, and then I will add some purple embossing powder on top of it. I am using Wow embossing pad to do the embossing. There is a good tip I learned on the internet. When your pad is dry, you can actually add some glycerin drops to it and it will work just fine. And after the black embossing powder is dry, I'm using embossing pen to add some purple accents, because I simply don't want to cover all the black parts. So let's talk a little bit more about the YouTube hop. There is 12 of us artists who prepare for you different projects. The main theme though, it's a purple, that's why it's called Purple Vibes, and we have very generous sponsors. If I'm not mistaken, we have 17 prizes to win from the sponsors, and all you have to do is watch our 12 videos, leave a comment underneath and subscribe to our channels if you didn't do so already. And be, of course, on the lookout for the individual giveaways some of us have. The modeling paste has dried, and I've already added a magical shaker from Lindy, Grab a Guide Gold. And now I'm adding a magical urban amethyst. I'm sprinkling it and then spraying it with water. I need more purple. I love purple so much, and I'm trying to add different shades of it. Now I'm using Lindy Starburst Wood Violet Blue and later Teapot Purple. I'm actually not drying after each application. I could have done that, but I don't mind. The colors will mix together anyway. And for the edges, I'm using the rest of the paint. After drying, the color got much darker than I have anticipated. So I'm using water-soluble oil pastels by Prima. This one is lavender, that's the only one I'm using. So basically I'm drawing on it randomly. And now with a brush I'm applying a little bit of water to blend it together perfectly. And for the edges again I'm using archival ink. The canvas is dry, so I will add some stamping now. The stamps comes from Rubber Dance, another of our sponsors. One is called Vintage Lace and the other College Elements. And again I'm using archival ink, which is permanent and honestly one of the best permanent black inks I have ever used. I will do some embossing now with another Rubber Dance stamp round in circles and with Lindy's embossing powder Sizzles Gold. I am happy with my background, so now I can start adding embellishments. I'm gluing the chipboard from SnipArt with a tacky glue. It's much easier to do it with tacky glue because it has a fine applicator and the chipboard is very intricate. And I'm adding pieces of torn paper from a 7-dot studio from the collection Paint Chip. To have more space between the layers, I'm adding pieces of cardboard. I also added a piece of gauze and here a little bit of sequins. It's a sequin, I just googled it because my pronunciation was not good here. So it's a piece of sequin and a few feathers. next step and more embellishments. That's MDF cock from SnipArt and some frame, and I'm covering them both with a black gesso. In general, I like to find the place for my embellishments before gluing them onto the project. But as you can see here, that's not always the case. Sometimes I just remove them after gluing them. And the glue is not drying straight away, so you have a space for error. You can move them around as much as you want before they actually glued permanently. And here are the cutouts of my butterflies, because this project is gonna be about purple and butterflies. I cut them out from the beautiful paper by Lemon Craft Vintage Time, and before doing so I actually applied a layer of black gesso at the back of the page, and then I covered it with shimmering violet, so the back of the butterflies is not actually white, but it's shimmering violet. Of course, I was not able to cut out the antennae of the butterflies, and I actually just learned that word, so again my pronunciation might not be very good. Beforehand I actually completely forgot how that is called, and I was thinking to use the word the sticking out thingy, but that's not good. So to do antennae I used the black scissor, and okay, it's time consuming to do that, but well, it's worth it. Here I am adding some homemade cabochons with some meaningful work. And then I will be adding sequins and beads and micro beads. To do so, I'm using 3D matte gel. I'm putting it on the small plate and I'm mixing it with the beads, and like that I'm gluing with my spatula on the project. Here I am adding some shimmering touches with Dealer and Rony, I think that's how you're supposed to say it, I'm not totally sure. And it's a shimmering violet again. And some splatter with PBO acrylic black paint. And then I will glue the butterflies. This project actually took me quite some time. And even though I speed up the video, it's still, I think, my longest video ever. I'm sorry for that, I hope I'm not boring you too much, but I just wanted you to see a step by step how to make this canvas. One of the final touches will be to add some Finabar wax. This one is aged brass. Like that, the project will have a little bit of golden shine to it. And that would be more or less all. Okay, I forgot about metallic stickers by Involves. And then I will add also some splatter at the very end. And once again, I want to remind you, if you want to take a part in the prize draw, you actually need to comment on our videos, and if you didn't subscribe to our channels, we would like you so much to do so, and like that you can take a part in this draw. And I'm telling you, 17 really gorgeous gift packs from our really, really generous sponsors. Thank you so much for to all the sponsors. And the list of sponsors you'll find at the beginning of this video in the description box below. That's it. I hope you've enjoyed my video, even though it's a little bit long. And thank you for taking part in this hop, in this YouTube hop. And good luck to you all. Hope to see you soon. Bye.